Hi and welcome to this first reflection on the world-building project I have decided to embark on. After tinkering around with smaller attempts to build fictional worlds for such things as pen and paper games, I have decided that I want to pursue a longer and more focused attempt at building a fictional world. And I want to do this by combining traditional world-building ideation with creating artworks, such as fantasy maps, which I will use as themes for the different episodes. And as part of that, I want to use these videos to tell stories about my world and as reflections on my process, and of course also to get other people's impressions and ideas involved. So if you have any of those, please let me know. I'm very keen on hearing what you think. The focus I want to set for this entire project is to explore the question of how human beings make sense of their lives in different historical settings and forms of culture. So I will mostly focus on the philosophical, cultural, and political aspects of my fictional world, and a bit less on the economic and technological sides, although material factors, of course, play into cultural development. So I want to use this project as a creative reflection on the human condition, because I think worldbuilding is a great way to get novel and critical perspectives on the real world, as opposed to an escapist way of running from it, as some people maybe tend to see it. For this initial video, I want to firstly showcase the world map I will be working with, which you can see right now. I experimented a lot with it already, but I will most likely keep changing things, and I'll be going a little bit into the process of how I made it, but mostly I will reflect a bit on the premise which I used to start building my world, and on the creative process I'm gonna go with. So let's get right into that. I will for now stick to a single world building promise, which I'm gonna introduce now. Imagine you could imprint the compound impression of what it is like to be you in this very moment into a physical object. Imagine you could write all your feelings, not only the ones fleeting over the surface, but your deeper mood, the sentiments that tell you how you feel in your life overall, into a small object. Now imagine that reading and writing from these artifacts would be the same process. Imagine that if another person wanted to read what you had just written onto the object, they would inevitably have to record their own impressions onto it, creating a complex mix of both sentimental worlds. Now imagine that these objects would be incredibly rare, especially the pure ones, those without any impressions recorded onto them. How would you feel about the existence of such objects? How would different societies think about them? And what would they do with them? They could be used as ultimate forms of historical transmission, giving an authentic glimpse into how it felt like to have lived in this world centuries ago, of course only at the cost of tainting this impression with our own. Recording your impressions could be considered a high honor for an individual, granting them an authentic form of immortality. Social groups could use them to amass certain qualities such as love, rage, tranquility, courage, happiness, lust, devotion, and so on. They could use them to manipulate others or as inquisitive devices to assess the state of mind or worthiness of another individual. They could make use of the objects at the same time, entering a deep form of community that could give rise to a union of lovers, families, or of cultural, spiritual, or political communities we can hardly imagine. Many forms of community would thus be built around them, and these communities would clearly distinguish themselves from those without the forms of tradition that thrive on the use of these objects. Capturing, stealing, or destroying them would be ultimate forms of harm, defeat, and insult, and they would trigger generation-lasting traumata and animosities. In short, these objects would form pillars of collective belonging and identity, and imagining that their origin would be unknown, there would be a million ways that people would give meaning to them. So this is the premise I will be working with. I know it's very limited and I don't have a theory of the origin of these objects yet, but they will be called Pillaisi in this world, or Pillai for singular, and they also give rise to the working title of this project, which is A Pillaisi, meaning something like stories about the cultures that formed around these objects. I might add further world building premises later on, but for now I will restrict myself to this one. Alright, as I said, I secondly want to reflect a bit on my process, because I think it might be interesting to hear other people's experiences on that, and maybe this will be helpful for you as well. I now started with creating a geographical map, which I created in four different steps after a lot of experimentation. The first step is to create the raw data for my fictional map by combining and editing real-world maps data, which gives you an elevation map, where for every pixel on your coordinate system there's a value for the altitude of that geographic location. You can display that as a binary color scale, as I did here with the black and white map, and since that does not look very interesting, I created a color scheme that I mapped onto this elevation map. You can use a graphical editor for both these steps. I used GIMP because it's free and open source and very nice. In the third step, I used both the elevation map from step 1 and the themed skin from step 2 to create a 3D rendering in Blender. And what it does is it takes your elevation map and constructs a 3D model from it, and then uses the skin as a texture for that. In the last step, now back in GIMP, I added some graphical elements to give it a nice look and feel. Now, the map sets the scene and boundaries for all cultures and stories to come into this world, but my main focus when bringing them into it will be to have a rich historical narrative that involves many different perspectives, rather than a single ahistorical lore and view on the world shared by every inhabitant of this world. So what I want is to have a collection of different perspectives from different ages. And in order to create this messy multi-perspective history, I will work in three steps. The first will be to pick four cultures that are prominent in one historical era, and I will work in a chronological order and sketch a quick portrait of their way of life. For this, I will be using what I call a ways of life snapshot, which is a fancy word for a sheet of paper on which I collect ideas under four different questions. Firstly, what material factors, such as geography, influenced the development of this culture? Secondly, what are the defining cultural traditions, group identities, and practices in this society? Thirdly, how do these traditions shape an individual's personal identity? That is, how is it like for person X to live in this culture? And lastly, based on all that, what sense has the culture given to human life and its place in the world? Obviously, I will center a lot of these ideas around the Palaisi, my world-building premise. Now, that will give me a few snapshots of these cultures, but they will still be anonymous and static because I won't have any historical development tied to them. Therefore, I will in the next step do something which I call a historical era snapshot, which is, again, a fancy word for a sheet of paper on which I collect ideas under, well, you guessed it, four different questions. Firstly, how did the central political bodies and sites, such as major cities within this culture, come into existence? Secondly, what kind of movements of people were there during this era? How did these cultures meet each other? Thirdly, what influences did these societies have on their respective cultural development, like what kind of ideas and traditions spilled over from one culture into the next? Lastly, what destructive events did come to pass during this era, and how did these societies vanish as they were once known? And with all that work done, I will have enough material to bring these cultures into life, and unsurprisingly, I have four ideas for that as well, which are, firstly, I will start to imagine what kind of myths and stories would have made it to a culture's successes, based on what came to pass during this era and what this culture was like and what they valued. Secondly, I will think about what famous names of personalities or maybe objects were transported through these stories. Thirdly, I will go into some explorations of the aesthetics of that culture, like what kind of fashion and iconography did they have. And lastly, I will bring it all together in a fictional map that incorporates a rich look and feel of that period of history. So summing up, I'm going with this 4x4 creative process, and I will do periodical updates where I present the results and some reflections on how this went. So let me know if you find this helpful, and I'm interested to hearing your thoughts about it.